Alright, hello everybody and welcome back to another War Thunder upcoming content video. Today we are getting a dev blog on the P-51H Mustang, which is great. We already covered the FV-102 Striker and before that the F4U4, and I said that I would hope to see the P-51H soon, and we are, so that is fantastic. Now, I just have to say, this is pretty damn cool what they did here, how they've laid out all, like, we've got the, I don't know what the fuck that is. We've got the bombs, the rockets, the machine guns, the bullets, which is pretty damn badass, the bazooka tubes, I'm assuming is what those are. I don't know exactly what those are. I'm assuming those are the unguided rockets inside the tubes. I don't know. I honestly don't know. I'd assume those are bazooka tubes, aren't they? That's what they were on the P-39s. I guess we'll find out. And it's right to call these bazookas, because that's actually what they were. Well, at least on the other planes. And not every fucking rocket in existence. I mean, you just have to start off by saying, wow, this plane, it's something special, I think. You know, I've always liked the look of the P-51, somewhat, honestly. There was a little bit that I never liked about it, but this one just looks different. It looks so much better. And then I get added by Nigger Faggot on Steam. It's great. But as I've been saying, especially with the F4U4, I stated that maybe the P-51H and the F4U4 is going to help me come back into Tier 4 for the United States. As I've explained, I haven't had good luck with the United States with their prop fighters at Tier 4. Well, they have some good ones, for sure. It's just, for every other nation, not counting Italy, I can go to Tier 4 and have some serious fun. But when I go to Tier 4 United States, I tend to not have that much fun, and I'm not exactly sure why. So that's why I think this plane might be the opportunity to help me with that, and I guess we'll find out. Anywho, the H variant of the famous P-51 Mustang was the most technologically advanced, top-performing, and final mass-produced Mustang modification of the series. Although this version of the legendary American piston-engine fighter arrived too late to take part in any hostilities during World War II, War Thunder pilots can look forward to pitting the arguably best Mustang version against its contemporaries in the upcoming update 1.71 New Era. Now, I had a dream last night. And the dream said, now I doubt it's real, but the dream said, Gaijin announced that there would be one more dev blog, and then one more day after that before the update came out. It's probably just a dream, but and this is that one more dev blog. Here's a little bit of history on the aircraft. In War Thunder, the long-awaited P-51H will make its way to the fourth rank of the American aviation tree with the upcoming update 1.71 New Era. There, it will provide seasoned War Thunder pilots with an aircraft that is, simply put, a true joy to fly, whilst preparing players that are just about ready to jump into jet era with the perfect aircraft to get used to high-speed dogfights. The lightweight... Are you telling me that this thing's a jet? The lightweight airframe of the P-51H, powered by a very powerful supercharged inline engine, allows the aircraft to reach a maximum speed of up to 472 miles per hour, or 760 kilometers an hour, on an altitude of 21,200 feet, or 6,500 meters. The loss in weight, compared to previous models, enhanced the handling characteristics of the P-51H, allowing it to climb faster and turn sharper. And as the last thing that it says here, I'm interested to see. The P-51H performs best at medium to high altitudes, where it can make maximum use of its advanced automatic supercharging system. That being said, players are best off investing some time into gathering altitude with their aircraft before engaging in combat. I never would have guessed. And although the P-51H takes less time to get to altitude than older modifications, I like the sound of that. I always had a problem with that with the P-51Ds. It will still get beaten in a climb by most contemporary Axis fighters. Nah, that's fine. So making sure to acquire the necessary altitude before heading into a fight is vital of importance. Or is of vital importance, damn it. As with previous models, the P-51H excels at a boom and zoom tactics, where it can take maximum advantage of its high speed and acceleration in an effort to catch its opponent off guard with a burst of deadly 50 caliber fire. Fans of ground attack will also be pleased to hear that, despite being obviously tailored towards achieving better performance, the P-51H didn't lose its traditional close air support abilities. Thus, players will now be bitching more about it in the comment section of not only this dev blog, but also the video, because close air support. Soon, all War Thunder pilots will be able to try out one of the fastest piston-engined production aircraft ever built for the American Air Force in the upcoming update 1.71 New Era. Clear prop. What? Are they turning it on? I hope not. I don't want it to slice my head off. I'll gib. That's the thing. Let's take a look at some of these pictures here. This plane is beautiful. Wow. What the fuck? Why is it so tiny? Oh my god, what the fuck? I've never seen that before. Why is the picture... It's huge, and then you click on it to open it, and it's just the smallest thing in the world. Okay, interesting. Are all of them like that? Yeah, what the hell? Yeah, look, they don't even have a freaking... Oh, their wallpaper is this one. They don't even have a freaking wallpaper set up for this. Are these ones small? No. Okay, interesting. When I saw this thing, I remember quite a while ago when I was making my original list videos, a lot of people were talking about the P-51H, and I kind of threw it on the list. I was like, hey, you know what, this would be pretty cool. And it looked nice, it looked fancy, and then it just kind of dropped off the side of the planet. And I know that the P-51H, out of all of the aircraft in the game that have been coming to the game, you know, there's a lot of them that a lot of people have wanted. There are some that I had never heard of, I had never heard anybody say, but apparently there were still people really wanting. But then there are that just small handful of aircraft that there's such a huge group of people in the community that want added to the game. The P-51H is one of those. I've heard so much about the P-51H over the past 2 years. So much, it's ridiculous. I've seen it in my YouTube comments. I've seen it on War Thunder forum posts over and over and over. And anytime, sometimes when there's a dev blog posted about a new U.S. fighter, people are like, well, are we ever going to get the P-51H? Now we are. We finally are getting the P-51H. That'll now make a lot of people happy, I'm sure. And for me personally, while I'm still more excited for the F4U4, but that's simply because of the attachment I have to that aircraft, I'm certainly not disappointed with seeing this aircraft. As I said, this could now be more of a reason for me to start enjoying Tier 4 United States again. And if that's the case, then that's two thumbs up for me to the P-51H. And maybe it'll turn into one of my favorite prop fighters, though I doubt it, because Germany is usually the one that holds that for me. But that's probably going to have to bring this one to an end. That is it. I don't know how many more dev blogs they have to do, because there, as far as I remember there, I mean, there's still, isn't, I'm sure there's a few more vehicles. I mean, we still have that other SU-6, but honestly, they probably don't even have to do a dev blog on that. And seeing that they've been releasing these dev blogs for a little while now, and they like to release them quite frequently, it's not like one every week, I'm pretty sure it's safe to say, and instead of saying soon when the update comes out, they say very soon, which, even though we know that soon means probably not soon at all, very soon usually means actually soon. They've been saying that in the replies to some of the comments on the website. And then, you know, you put everything else, you put the Facebook posts together and stuff like that. We've already had the digest, we've already had the dev server up at least once. And usually, I mean, I think they've done it a couple times in the past, but usually they'd only do it once, as far as I'm aware. But usually when all this stuff kind of accumulates together, that means the update is about to freaking come out. And that's probably where it's at right now. It's probably pushing, it's the bolts are bursting, it's about to pop. And hopefully it does, because I would like to see this thing in the game. Hopefully sometime soon. Also, did you guys get your compensation? Because I didn't get any, unless they changed it, I didn't get any compensation for that Tankers Day special. I don't know if I must have missed something, but it said that players who had already owned the vehicles plus the decoration would get compensation on the September 11th. It's September 14th. I haven't gotten anything. There was no booster. I didn't get any like gold, anything like that. Like I said, I assumed it was just 500 gold. Didn't get any of it, so don't know. I sent a ticket just to make sure that I didn't miss. I did get compensation, but I didn't notice it. I don't know. But, yeah, let me know in the comments below about that, but also let me know in the comments below what you think about the P-51H. While I'm sure most of you are probably excited, there's probably a handful of you that are excited for something else. Feel free to let me know what that is. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next War Thunder upcoming content video.